The value chain model supports the identification of a company's cost and value differentials, which in turn determine its strength and weaknesses that sustain or hinder its ability to create competitive advantage. Before getting into the details of this analysis of competitive differentials, I will briefly state the principles that should be used when adopting this framework. Unlike external analysis, where the models of the five competitive forces and PEST are applied to a generic company, the point of view of the value chain is that of the specific company analyzed. Secondly, value chain is both firm and industry specific, so it refers to a specific strategic business unit working in a specific business area. Companies having a diversified portfolio and operating in different markets will have to develop as many value chains as the number of SBUs they control. The last application principle is based on the fact that the model is relatively flexible. It was first developed for manufacturing companies, but it can be adapted to other sectors like the service one. So, as a consequence, primary and support activities proposed in a model can be reviewed and a value chain can be remodeled on the basis of specific activities carried out by the company analyzed and influencing its cost and value. When remodeling the value chain, however, keep in mind that no matter how deeply you modify the traditional template, the following features of the model will always hold true. There will always be a distinction between primary and support activities. You will always be looking for cost and value differentials determining competitive advantage. And you should always carry out an internal analysis identifying positive and negative differentials of cost and value within three levels. The level of the single activities, the level of the links among internal and external activities, and eventually, the level of the overall system of activities.